Hi guys, I am Michele and 2 years ago I made this video where I was explaining the basis of the hydrofoil for the water sport. Several people asked me if anything changed in this period of time and my answer is yes, a lot changed dramatically. Just to consider that a few years ago my first hydrofoil has been a Fanatic High Aspect with an AR of 5.7, now typically 5.7 is considered like a low aspect, and this shape with an AR of 11 are considered almost high aspect. Moreover, a few years ago it was impossible to think to surf with a product like this, while now it is a reality and it's very, very enjoyable and funny. Moreover, a few years ago it was impossible to think to go fast with an hydrofoil with an AR high but also with a very big area, while now it is also a reality. And moreover, a few years ago it was really needed to use some screw to mount our hydrofoil, while now, thanks to the system like the Slingshot One Lock, it's very easy to assemble an hydrofoil in 15 seconds without any screw. So yes, a lot has changed, and in this video I want to take these three hydrofoils just as an example to show to you which is my vision of the present and probably also about the future of the hydrofoil. Now, let's start speaking about the aspect ratio or AR. It is a number and it defines how much stressed is the shape of an hydrofoil. So it is the division between this size and this size. The greater it is, the more stressed will be the front wing, the lower it is, the more, let's say, fat will be the front wing. I mean, this point you can imagine to have it like tears, so with a very, let's say, fat profile. Why the AR is very, very important? Because until a few years ago, if you wanted to surf, you had to use a low AR, because a low AR means that you have a very good turning capability, but in that case you will be suffering about the speed, the glide and the efficiency. On the other side, if you wanted to have a very good efficiency and a very good speed, you had to go to hydrofoil with high AR. Moreover, until a few years ago, the area was the typical parameter used to define the lift of an hydrofoil. What I mean is that an hydrofoil with an area of 900 like this one have less lift than an hydrofoil with an area like the Indiana, which is 1600. Is it real? Yes, but now the area is not the only parameter to evaluate the lift. Since it happens very often while testing new product to us, we have been very impressed, because hydrofoil with less area but with a higher AR had a very much better lift compared to hydrofoil with less AR but greater area. So like I said, the area is an important parameter, but you need to mix it also with the AR. And in this case, the AFS Enduro 900 is a perfect example of this. Why? Because it has an AR of 11, so high AR, but you can really also surf some waves. Much probably you cannot do very, very steep turn, but you can surf waves, and we did it with very good success. Guys, this has an AR of 11. Until a few years ago, it was unthinkable to surf waves with this product, but I tell you, if you do it, you will enjoy it, because it's now a reality. Moreover, until a few years ago, if you wanted to use an high AR hydrofoil, you had to be very, very good in the management of the hydrofoil. Now, thanks to products like this one, the brands really found a way to decrease massively the skills needed to enjoy at 100% each product. So in this case, it is an hydrofoil that can really be used by anyone who have already some practice on the hydrofoil, but you don't have to be a pro. Finally, now thanks to the increase and to the improvement of the construction and of the working technologies, it's possible to make some profile like this one, which is a unique factor of AFS. It's let's say related to the designer that developed this front wing, and thanks to this profile we have been really surprised because we found that the Enduro in this case have a very good low-end stall speed, so it means that you can really decrease a lot your speed, but the hydrofoil will stay up, will not go down like other hydrofoil do. And moreover, we are really convinced that thanks to this profile, the behavior in the white water is very, very good, is very, very smooth. Another aspect that I want to mention is the construction, because until a few years ago, it was like this. So you had the front wing, a few screws to connect to the fuselage, and then some screws to connect to the stub. Is it yet valid? Yes, for several products, but more and more we are seeing product with a sort of monoblock construction like the Indiana one. In fact, as you can see here, we have the front wing, which is partially integrated with the fuselage. This has several advantages. First of all, you have less screws, and it's good because you will save some time while mounting. Moreover, the construction at the end of the day is very robust. And finally, the designer now has really the possibility to develop the profile of the front without having almost any limitation in terms of size and in terms of profile. So it means that here, in this case, Gunnar Binjas developed the profile, having really a possibility to use all this part of the shape and really to go very deep in the development of all the surfaces. And at the end of the day, you feel it in the water, because thanks to this new construction, I have really the impression that the smoothness of ride is really the next level. Last topic that I want to address here regarding the assembly, because until now we saw several hydrofoil, almost all the hydrofoil, that need some screws to be used to connect the stub with the fuselage and with the mast. But now I'm seeing the first one, the Slingshot One Lock, which need zero screws, and it is a very good advantage, because in this way you don't have any issue about corrosion and you save a lot of time while preparing the gear. And now I want just to show to you how quick can be to mount the Slingshot One Lock. In this case we have the front wing, which is integrated with the fuselage, and on the other side we have the stub, which is integrated with part of the fuselage. The assembly is very straightforward and very, very fast. Here we have the mast with the hole. We put the front wing inside here, like this. Then I will take the back part, insert it, and then here I have this block. I put it here and I press it. Now the hydrofoil is completely assembled. As you can see, we have zero screws, and in my opinion, more important, the assembly time is really reduced at the minimum. I think that in 10 seconds you can mount an hydrofoil. Moreover, you can also add this simplicity with the simplicity to mount the mast on the board, because also in this case the Slingshot RTS solution is very, very fast, quick, and does not need any tool to go in the water. Really, I think that in 30 seconds you can go in the water starting from the product inside the bags. Okay, so coming to the conclusion, in my opinion, in just 2 years a lot has changed in the hydrofoil design and uses. Now something which was unthinkable 2 years ago is the reality, and I am really wondering how will be the future. Because speaking only about AR, probably in a 2 years time frame from now, the AR11 could be considered probably medium or low. I don't know. Anyhow, I'm really looking forward to see all the development that the brands will push on the market. Guys, thanks a lot for your attention. If you like our content, please think to like and subscribe. Now I go working to other reviews. See you next time. Bye, Michele.